Hi, YouTubers. I'm glad you're here. Thank you very much for joining me. They have two alerts going on at Yellowstone. One I think is kind of odd, may not be, and that's the closure of the West Thumb Geyser Basin area. Now, you guys know that I've been covering West Thumb. That's the area where they got the crack under the lake, and the volcano's been screaming, a lot of heat coming up. Evidently, in a small building there on September 6th, they had smoldering, lithium batteries. Now, when lithium batteries catch on fire, they can burn for hours or even days. But this fire or this closure has been going on for a week and a half, and I have to wonder how many lithium batteries do they have stored? It's evidently near the bookstore in a small building. So the area, they said, is going to be closed until the batteries have fully discharged and the fumes have dissipated from the area. So, fully discharged? Are they still got batteries that they're using? I don't know. It just seemed really odd. A week and a half since this fire and the area is still closed. 10 earthquakes today alone within the Yellowstone area, the largest being a magnitude 2.4. It was a shallow earthquake, 6.5 miles below sea level. This here is the monitor, the borehole. It's a very deep well under the ground, probably over 600 feet, maybe about 600 feet dug under the ground for the Madison River area. This is that earthquake, and it actually comes in as a magnitude, let me bring it down, a magnitude 2.56 right there. And I'll show you its signature. Go back to the spectrogram, and we'll go back to its signature, take up, okay, right there. And you can see the sharpened point. Yeah, I had a troll on here. You know who you are. Yeah, it's from that other website that I was kind enough to share you, that you can look at the earthquakes as they come in live on the monitor. And you'll see these are sharpened points here. And according to USGS, we got four different types of signatures for earthquakes. Sharpened points means tectonic-like earthquakes. Shallow, when they're rounded, means shallow volcanic earthquakes. If it was a surface event that starts out small and gets louder and then slowly gets quieter again. And the harmonic signatures are little waves, kind of like volcanic signatures, but a lot smaller. Here's an article on Wired.com magazine. We got volcanic tectonic earthquakes. See that? Little sharpened points. LP earthquakes. They are rounded. Harmonic tremors. Okay. Earthquakes, and it's talking about the movement of the magma causing these earthquakes. By this, don't tend to be large. Rarely are they larger than a magnitude 5. And usually they're less than a magnitude 3. They will become shallower and they might even move laterally. I've talked about how the magma's been moving sideways, horizontally is what I call it, as the magma tries to find the easiest path out of the crust down there at Grant by Little West Thumb. I've talked a lot about the earthquakes that have been happening there. These earthquakes generated by the magma cracking the rock along the way up are called volcanic tectonic earthquakes. You'll also get long period LP earthquakes under volcanoes as bubbles form and escape from the magma during its ascent. Like VT earthquakes, LP earthquakes gradually begin and fade away rather than being abrupt events. So if a swarm of earthquakes under a volcano is a combination of VT and LP events, it's a pretty good sign that the earthquakes are being caused by magma moving into shallower parts of the volcano. However, as the magma gets closer to the surface, VT events tend to go down as LP events increase. They also occur as hybrid or mixed earthquakes that have some of the VT and LP characteristics. I've been showing you those. A third type of shaking can occur under volcanoes, and that is harmonic tremors. This is small but constant shaking, possibly caused by the turbulent motion of the magma in the conduit. Typically, when volcanologists are watching a volcano that is restless, the onset of harmonic tremors is a good sign that an eruption is likely to occur in minutes or days, and then, of course, sometimes years. Often they'll tell you that these earthquakes are caused by the water being heated and coming up and creating what they call hydrothermal fluids. But those are just usually only a few kilometers under the surface. A couple is two, and a few is three. Is that not correct? If you look at places where geothermal energy is being tapped, or at a restless caldera like Yellowstone, earthquake swarms are common from hydrothermal fluids, but only if there are a few kilometers below the surface. Yeah, there's some here. This is a 3.6 miles, 3.3 miles, 3.9 miles, 1.6. But we got others that are 5 miles below, 4 miles below, 6.5 miles below, 9.5 miles below, and 4.4 miles below. The deepest one, which was supposedly a 0.4, they're saying was 9.5 miles below sea level. So if you really think about it, Yellowstone is about a little more than 26,000 feet above sea level, and all earthquakes are measured from sea level. So yeah, these are, if you're going to go from the crust of the earth down, these are really deep earthquakes. But let's go back to this 0.4, 10:43 universal time. It's actually a magnitude 1.48. And I took this one from the borehole. Again, borehole 207. Let's look at the spectrogram. Okay. Let's take a look at its signature. Very, very sharp points. Yeah, volcanic earthquakes. 9.5 miles in depth. Yeah, it's definitely not a 0.4. All right, let's go to Little West Thumb. There's been a lot of popping of the rock going on. See that? All the heat that came up. Got one down here that looks a little bit bigger. Oh, that's two right in a row. Soda Butte's been screaming. This is probably about an hour and a half before I pulled the files. Right there, you can see it got so loud that it went quiet that the equipment couldn't pick it up. And it looks like there's a lot of popping going on here too. Now remember, this is the northeast area of the park. And then we got a bunch in red right here too. Yeah. Now see these lighter lines? That's hot water and gases. You know, I've been watching Yellowstone, 11 years, and seen how it has evolved over the years. And those of you that have been with me have seen that too. Yeah. The monitor for Maple Creek. Yeah, we got drum beats going on when I pulled the file right there. Let's go to the signature. Now, this is not Denny Creek that was showing the drum beats earlier in the week. And in my last report the week before. This is Maple Creek. You can see there's lots of earthquakes. They're only reporting 10 of them. What time is that one? 4:19. Okay, 4:19. There's the spectrogram. We'll go back to the signature. They're saying that's a magnitude 2.0. That's the last one they reported, or the first one, I should say, they reported within the last 24 hours. That one was actually a magnitude 2.52. Let me bring it down so you can see it. One of the biggest ones would probably be this one right here at 1334. Yeah, look at the heat that came up. They're saying that's a magnitude 2.4. Well, we can tell by the signature that it's actually larger. Yeah, I'm just kind of jumping around. Here's that Soda Butte, 2352. This would have been last night, Universal Time. You see it screaming right here. And there's the signature. Yeah, I almost missed that one. So how many batteries did they have stored there by the work, by the bookstore? Yeah, a week and a half and it's still toxic? I don't know. And all these recent earthquakes. And so I thought I would check the tilt meter. Now this is the borehole for the Madison River for the last week. And see it, yeah, it took a drop there around the 9th. Looks like it's pretty well holding steady. Well, maybe going down a little bit. And then, yeah, the earthquakes for the last week. And then the last month, let's take a look. It looks like it's holding steady there at the borehole. Now, Yellowstone Lake, that's a different story. It looks like it was going up around the 11th. Started coming back down in the one direction, but the other one is still going up. This is the ground that's rising. I talk about the tilt and the uplift that's going on. Yeah, see that? And this is Grant. This would be part of the area more likely that's closed. It's going up a little bit. And we'll come down. Yeah, lots of a shake and lots of quake. And then the last 30 days. Yeah. So, what are your thoughts? Put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.